For instance, the trainers, okay, they're very distinctive. The belt is very distinctive. But you know, I'm sorry I'm having to describe this to you, but it's very difficult to describe unless you've actually been in this position.
Was he wearing his watch? Was his watch
you, won't, you
can't tell.
You can't tell. You can't tell.
The focus was on that river was because of Darren's jacket.
Exactly.
The fact is, as you told us in last week's meeting, that jacket was put in the back of that boot by Darren.
Yeah.
Now, what everyone's expecting us to believe is that Ambrose left his phone in the car, but he went to the trouble to go to the back of that car, get his jacket out, close after the trash we're talking, get out, open that boot, take his jacket out, close the boot, run down an alley, drop a jacket he didn't even need.
Yeah.
Sorry, we're not buying it.
And then being so happy that Daddy owes. How can he be so happy after all that fight?
On Monday, the meeting, you said at 5 to 3, Inspector Wise upped that to a medium.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you didn't receive the call until 15:48 from Alpesh, stating he'd found that jacket.
Yeah.
So how's that possible?
Yeah.
There's a lot that did not make sense from that meeting.
I hear what you say, but when we show you the map, of the where the jacket was found, okay?
But why did
you take the jacket? The river that we looked at?
Yeah.
Okay, remember that we went down there and we looked at the river?
Yeah, that's the Morgue bypass.
It wasn't that river.
It's not that one.
It wasn't that
river. You're on about the one, you've got the canal and then you got the river afterwards.
Yeah.
You're on about the river afterwards.
Yeah, well, that I was worried about, that he went in.
If you walk along the edge of the canal, you've got the river one side and the canal the other side.
Is that right, Barry?
Well, as a map, it's actually Pimsbrook. And the next one is Riverlea.
Yeah.
That's Riverlea Navigation.
Right.
That's what it says on the map. It's Riverlea Navigation that the body was found in.
It's gone further from where that jacket was. It's got across one, and that further across again.
So
and then
three, the third sort of stretch of water.
And then that.
That's what I said.
The route of that river
expands and opens.
And it goes down.
That's
further.
What I was
and
worried
it
about.
It doesn't meet the river where the jacket was. Until, a hell of a long way down. So it's a completely separate.
Well, we've always thought the jacket was planted anyway.
Yeah.
Because
when we
got there, the jacket
was dry.
It's apparently supposed to have been there for 3 days.
Yeah.
It was bone dry. It had been frosty all night. The jacket was bone dry.
It's pouring. It's hot.
There was no slug trails or anything like that on it, which we'd expect it to be laying there 3 days.
I mean, there's a possible explanation as to where he is now, okay? But let's wait and see what happens at the postmortem. Okay, because, we haven't got all the information. And this is, for us, this is the most important part for us, because this is going to give us an indication as to, whether there's any overt foul play.
Yeah.
Yeah?
You're gone and I gotta stay.
Tuesday, went to see him.
Went to see him to see if he knew anything.
And then phoned him about 20 minutes ago.
And phoned him about 20 minutes ago and said we found a body. Yeah, to see if he knew anything.
Je t'aime quand c'est là.
One typical search, obviously, managed to be buried and we'll be straight down. Okay? It's your legal entitlement, as I said to Suresh, to view the body. Okay? And that's okay, Chris. It's either before the post mortem or after the post mortem. It's your decision. Okay? I will say to you, okay, and I'm going to be open and candid with you, okay, I would advise against it at this stage. Okay? But it's your right. It is your right, and I respect that.
Okay? Well, what would be different at any other stage?
Because what happened is they will prepare the body that we have, they will prepare that body for the post mortem. The body is not prepared. The body has literally been lifted from a river, and it's been in a river for a significant amount of time, and there's a significant amount of debris, decomposition as well, that is obviously that would take place as a result of a body being in a river for a certain amount of time. The body has literally been lifted, it's been wrapped, and it's been brought to the mortuary, and that is the condition that the body is in. And I can tell you now, because I haven't seen the body. Literally, I've seen the photographs of the crime scene. You will not be able to make an identification, a visual identification. Clothing, there is still clothing on the body. Nothing has been removed from the body. The body has not been touched at all. And that would not happen until tomorrow. So, obviously, when the process of the post-mortem starts. So, I've got to tell you that, Alex, and I've got to tell you that, Ruth. Okay? Because it would be remiss of me if I didn't. So, but it's your decision, and that's why I'm here.
Oh yeah. Would you believe me if I told you?
Again, tomorrow, after the post-mortem, where the body will be in better condition because it would have been cleaned. So it's a complete
matter. And you will be able to see the whole body then, after the post-mortem, without the clothes?
There is not a whole body. So it's... There is. It's difficult to describe because I haven't seen the body itself, but the body's been in water for a good period of time.
You're going to do DNA, not DNA. You're going to do
fingerprint
test, aren't you?
What the coroner told us. Becky Smith told us that you're going to identify him by fingerprints, and we don't understand that because it's that badly decomposed.
With all due respect to Becky, okay, Becky isn't an investigator. Okay, she's a coroner's officer. And she hasn't seen.
She said that.
Yeah. So I'm telling you now, there will be no fingerprints.
But you haven't seen it either.
I've seen.
No, you haven't seen Ambrose's body.
Ambrose's
body.
No, I've seen photographs. I've seen crime scene photographs. I've seen the photographs. So, but I haven't actually seen the body in person. But I can tell you now that the identification
through the photograph
is more likely to come from DNA.
Yeah.
So DNA would have to be extracted tomorrow, and the DNA would have to be then compared to the DNA that we've got, and that takes 48 hours.
Will you believe me when I say affairs of the heart, together we've grown, if ever apart, all I want you to know is your love is life-changing, and I couldn't be the same without you, darling, your love is life-saving. You always catch me when I fall. When the tour bus drop off and I like lock off and I'm a mere more.
It may well be, Chris, when they remove the clothing, okay, which is going to be difficult in itself, there may be a mark on the body that may be visible, for instance, a specific tattoo.
Or a leg.
Or a leg that we might be able to, you know, say, oh, we're almost 100% sure now that this is Ambrose. But it may not be the case, I don't know. Because the body's covered in debris.
What you looking? Promoter belly full and all the fans gone home. I'm glad that you're more than a friend. When your love is life changing. And I couldn't be the same without you, darling. Your love is life saving.
But it really depends. I mean, I don't know how long that particular body has been in the river. I don't know how long it's been. And
be the same without you, darling. Your love is life saving. You always catch me when I'm falling.
There's people just like you and me, we'll pass them in the traffic. That never fall in love and some may have it, set me lucky.
No, for
it's happened for a long time.
There's a lot of...
You don't think it could have been somewhere else and then done there later?
Well, we'll...
You'll find that.
Yeah, right. Yeah. I mean, there's one question that I will be asking the pathologist is, can we tell whether that body has drowned?
Yeah.
Or that body was dead before he went in there.
Yeah. Yeah.
And under certain circumstances they can, but because of the length of time that body may be in there, that may be compromised. So it's, we'll have to wait and see.
I'm not fortunate enough to have somebody. Some just cannot see beyond the flesh and it's so funny. Never get too caught up in yourself to feel the magic. True love come and pass you by in life, but it's so tragic. Opportunity is good, so take it while you have it. Don't wait till you are panic.
I know you've got that trust, but I mean, I can assure you I've been doing this a long time. Okay, and
yeah, you know, I'm saying that it's one of the good forms.
I've worked on murder investigations for a long time.
Well, the last man here, they would make a big mistake. Left hand gone for good and miss out something we're great. Loyal and full of faith when enough of them a move fake. Our things separate, we can't separate, cause I would miss you, Peter. And I...
Probably in the water, but the back... So, and the bum was just above the water. So that's all that was...
All that's visible is the back and sort of the bum area.
So yeah, that's what
that's all. Body was found just by a worker who was walking along, checking the river, at about...
Because the newspapers have reported it.
23 in the morning? Afternoon.
It was environmental agency staff that were checking
it's
the
not,
water
for
pollution. It was...
It's not an area where people would walk.
It was just...
Can't do without you, darling. Yes, and I would miss you, baby. Girl, you know I love you bad. Affairs of the heart. Together we've grown. Fall apart. All I want you to know, woman, your love is life changing. And I wouldn't be the same without you, darling. Your love is life saving. You always catch me when I fall. When I'm away, it's like my songs always, cause you're not near to hear me. If I...
Now the DNA will be, if they can get DNA, which, you know, I've seen DNA been extracted from bodies that have been dead a long time, a lot longer than...
Lost my way, I'd know I'd be okay, cause you'd be there to cure me. I know man, I can see things clearly. You're genuine because you love sincerely. You never let me down, not even nearly.
And all I would say is what I believe, okay? The description of clothing matches what we believe Ambrose to be wearing at the time, or wearing at the time of his disappearance on the 24th, on the Friday,
the Saturday
morning.
The Daddy O CCTV, in my opinion, that is exactly the same clothing as well.
But you cannot identify that body that we found.
Yeah.
And you're never going to be able to identify that body visually. Never.
So I would never know whether it is Ambrose.
Yeah, you will, because there may be a mark on that body as you've just described.
Like the knee.
If it's on the bone,
yeah.
That's one way it could be done possibly. Or there may be a tattoo that may still be visible that may be able to be identified, or failing that, the DNA.
Okay.
Or even dental records if we're in a position to be able to do that.
Lost my way, I'd know I'd be okay, cause you'd be there to cure me. I know man, I can see things clearly. You're genuine because you love sincerely. You never let me down, not even nearly, not even barely. Girl, you know I love you bad. Some to the laughter and don't see the tears. Some to the courage and don't see the fear. Some for themselves and they don't intend to share. Some say I love and only pretend to.
Did he have tattoos on his leg?
No, he had one massive tattoo on his right side, just done, of a woman, of a Mexican type woman.
Quite a large one.
Yeah, all took all up this side. He's got
got loads. He's got, yeah, but he's got one on his neck, but it's not legend. He covered up the word legend. It's of a rose, but it looks like a load of ink just being slapped.
Tend to care. Well, enough of them are just miscongeniality. Them pretty face and them not face reality. Well, them are quantity. Woman, you are quality. Girl, you know I love you bad. Affairs of the heart. Together we've grown. If ever apart, all I want you to know is your love is life changing. I couldn't be the same without you, darling. Your love is life saving.
Those, if this was foul play,
immediately,
but they're here as well, so it's not just us, they will be here.
In my mind, I see you clear as a bell, precious child. Precious child in my soul.
I warn you now that there hasn't been any cleansing of that body at all, okay? Which would be the case if it was after the post-mortem.
We were just told that you've had it since the 19th, you've had Ambrose.
Yeah, that's what we've just been told.
Yesterday.
But who told
you? There is a hole that can never be filled. But in my heart, there is hope.
He's actually, the body's actually in that room.
What, Ambrose is?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's not going to be. Because obviously he's prepared it.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Ambrose is just there.
Okay, so it's...
Give me still in my heart. You live on, always there, never gone, precious child. Left too soon, and though it may be true that we're apart, you will live forever in my heart. In my plans, I was the first to leave. Precious child, but in this world, I was left here to grieve. Precious child, in my soul, there is a hole that can never be filled. But in my heart, there is hope, and you are with me still. In my heart, you left too soon, though it may be true that we're apart, you will live forever in my heart. God knows I wanna hold you, see you, touch you, and maybe there's a heaven. And someday I will again. Please know you're not forgotten until then. In my heart, you live on, always there, never gone, precious child. You left too soon.